Welcome everybody to another unboxing video on the channel. Today we are doing something weird and different. It may look a little bit weird with the aesthetic right now going on, but we're doing a pretty big figure to say the least here. So it's very, very different in the setup when we do bigger things in here because I've still just moved in. We're still trying to get the setup going and whatnot too. I'm your guys host, Dakota Morgan, coming to you from Phoenix, Arizona, from the Neighborhood Podcaster, Animal Caretaker, Dinosaur Enthusiast, Toy Unboxer, Video Game Streamer, Comic Writer, all the jazz like that. We are here today. I'm excited. We're taking a look at a piece of my childhood. The newly released Extreme Chompin' Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous Spinosaurus by Mattel. Awesome. I never figured I would get a Spinosaurus figure, let alone we've had three, but this is the first one in the United States we're able to pick up, and it's glorious. I never figured my childhood, because I love the Spinosaurus, I grew up on Jurassic Park 3. That's when I became a Jurassic Park fan. Was when I was a kid, Jurassic Park 3. So I love any interpretation you give me of the Spinosaurus. Scientifically inaccurate, yes. But the fact we get one and it looks this good is so beautiful. Let's take a look here at the packaging. This guy just came out. They're at Target's right now for $29.99. Go pick it up. God, I almost just want to leave it in the packaging. Does this mean we're going to see him in Season 3 of Camp Cretaceous on the good old Netflix? Who knows? We don't know as of yet, but I'm hoping. I'm really hoping. It's supposed to pop up in the last movie, so maybe Spider will pop up. Here we have the little artwork here for Spinosaurus, the classic Camp Cretaceous packaging. You know, we have the campground in the back here, the wood and style, the Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous logo. A big, hefty guy, to say the least here. And then we have the back, which is awesome. Some cool printing on here, some digital artwork with a gigantic bite. We'll take a look at that in a second here, you know, one. Also, the Albertosaurus and the Sarcosuchus are on here. We've unboxed those guys in the past on the channel, so if you want to take a look at that. I got some Skizors over here. Let's take a look. But even just in packaging, this guy looks absolutely stunning and gorgeous. If you just want to keep him packaging for your collection, oh, absolutely stunning and gorgeous figure here. Let's get him out here. Now, is he stuck on the bottom? By golly, he is. That means we have to do is we have to take him apart. Yeah, folks, I don't know. It's weird. I know for a fact how some people feel about the Spinosaurus in Jurassic Park 3. I know this. Everyone says, oh, it's scientifically inaccurate now. It is. It very, very much is. Yeah. But you know what, though? I still think it's a really cool Jurassic Park dinosaur, you know? We accept the Indominus Rex as a fake dinosaur, and we still live with it. So we can live with the Spinosaurus just being some weird thing. And there's a lot of history to the Spinosaurus as well, too. Oh my god, he looks so gorgeous. This is awesome. Never had a figure like this when I was a kid. All we had was the rubber Spinosaurus, which I love and I have in the collection. And then also the animatronic one. But man, look at this beautiful Spinosaurus just straight out of the movie here. Straight out of the movie. Stands up perfectly. The tail and it has articulation here. We got the arms that do move up and down. We got the legs that move, of course. So we can stand in different spots. The feet move from side to side, per usual with the large theropods. Maybe the smaller theropods. The head does move in a very cool fashion here. Take a look at the full articulation on that head. We got a button here that goes rah, rah, rah. An awesome, awesome figure here. But take a look even here. You can take a look at the sculpt and the mold of this dinosaur. Move on to that next. Very cool. Ooh, even the little detail for you to get some extra posability. They do the classic thing that Mattel loves to do, a little feature, is to move the legs inside the side. Awesome. Really makes it great. The mold here we'll take a look at looks straight out of the movie here. It's that head sculpt, the fine detailing with the scales or the reptile-like pattern on here. We have it on the frill too. It's kind of got this little bit on that rubbery side, harder plastic on the sides, but kind of on the rubber side here on the face. The teeth as well, of course. I think that extra large tongue there. But the Spinosaurid. Awesome. And of course the tail here, like, it just goes all the way down the bumps, the crevices here. The toenails are painted, which is awesome. It's not one where it's the toenails and fingernails or talon nails aren't painted. Talon is not painted, but that's okay. We at least got the toes on there. A lot of detail added to that. You know, some black flaking there, cool, which makes it really stand out on the gray. You know, the ridges here. And then we move on to the color scheme. The color scheme, like I said, looks straight out of the movie. You know, we have the red with the brown, that kind of white tan line from JP3 that we've come to expect with it. You know, not many of the blues on here, to say the least. We don't really have that much of the blues, but I still think this guy, he looks way, even that front just looks menacing. A little bit on the cartoony teeth right there. But you turn to the side like that, not at all. Like those eyes, those damn eyes. Extremely beautiful dinosaur figure, to say the least here. That's a thumbnail right there, except it's not going to be. Awesome. Well worth the price of admission, and maybe this will get folks to like Spinosaurus, or kids who don't know what the Spinosaurus is, get some down a science hole, or history hole, or maybe even the JP3 hole. Who knows? There is one previous version like this that is kind of like this color, but a lot more darker grays. I don't think it looks as good though as this beautiful Spinosaurus. And then there's one out there, if you can find it, is blue and yellow, which I think is cool, but still. So this is our third try, and able to get one of these guys is awesome. Beautiful. Even that rib cage right there too, a nice little detail. Beautiful dinosaur, folks. Make sure you guys go pick it up. If you're watching this, you like to collect, make sure you go pick it up. We need to show them that we love Spinosaurus, and that all this years of waiting for America to get theirs is really, really worth it. So thank you, everybody. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more toy unboxing videos, more video games, more Dino Times, more all the jazz like that, podcast stuff, as well as make sure you guys subscribe and leave a like in the video if you like it. I'm on Twitter at DakotaMorgan3, Instagram at Dakota_Morgan97. And if you want to catch me live, raw and uncut, I am on Twitch, CodaRex97. Thank you, everybody. You all rock. And remember, folks, stay creative, everyone.